Thank you for inviting me to be with you. That better? I'm picking up. Wonderful. Thank you so much for inviting me to be here with you this morning. It's wonderful to come and share with you this morning. It's a beautiful, beautiful morning. When I drove up from much further south in the county this morning, I drove up through glorious countryside, coming past the cows in the field just a little bit further up the road. And it's very easy on a morning like this to appreciate the wonderful gift God has given us in the world that we have around us. And God has been generous to all of us. He's given us this wonderful world, and he's made all of us in his image, each of us unique with our own gifts and talents. So as I go through the presentation, keep in mind God's generosity to us, just how much love he has shown to us. Now, before I go any further, I would like to say thank you. Thank you to all of you who already give so very, very generously, financially, and of your time and talents. I know that there must be an awful lot of hard work that goes into a church looking as beautiful as this church looks this morning. I was quite taken away by its beauty when I arrived and spent some time before the 8 a.m. service just marveling in your beautiful, beautiful church and thinking how much work it must take all of you to keep it so beautiful. So thank you. It really is appreciated. Now, I do have to go on and talk about money. Nobody really likes to talk about money. I'm from Yorkshire. I have no qualms about talking about money. And it's important that we do, because without money, there would be no mission and the ministry that supports that mission. So, if we think about money in relation to ourselves here today, this is how much it costs each week. And we'll see on the next slide the exact figure. And that's 2,688. Now, keep that in mind, but don't get too caught up in it. It's there. But thinking about money, it's okay to talk about money. Even if you're not from Yorkshire, you can still talk about money. Half of the parables were about money. Jesus wasn't scared of talking about money and our response and our duties financially. And we shouldn't be scared of it either. We've got the lovely tale of the widow's mite, and she gave so generously. So, coming back, this is what it costs each week to run the church. So, on the next slide, and in your packs that you've got, you'll have a brochure that shows you how that money is spent each week. I'm not going to go through each individual cost because you've got those details and you can take those away and look at them later on at home. But if I come on to the biggest one, which is the Dawson shared costs. Now, there's a lovely pie chart up on the screen, but you've also got a really nice leaflet in your pack. And that's the lovely Leslie Jones doing Ride and Stride last year. That gives you all the details. I'd just like to highlight a couple of the sections. The lovely big fuchsia pink section. And that's what it costs per £100 for our clergy. And that's housing and pensions and insurance. It doesn't all go to Simon, I promise you that. It's the overall cost. You get that much. The other large section, the green section, that's training clergy and lay readers and authorised ministers and curates. Over the next 5 years, over 40% of our stipendiary clergy are going to reach retirement age, and it's very important that we look to those people coming through to take on those roles and responsibilities. Do have a look at the leaflet. If you have any questions, I'll be around after the service. Please feel free to ask me. If I have the answer, I'll give it to you straight away. If I don't know the answer, I will find out for you. So, where does this money come from? Well, from yourselves mainly. You're very generous. Your planned giving brings in over £1,000 a week. And that's the giving that comes through the standing orders and the envelopes. Another big chunk is the tax that's recovered. Good work from your treasurer and your gift aid secretary, making sure that all the money that can be reclaimed is claimed, and it's almost like free money. So, moving on to our personal relationship with how much we give, it's very useful to think about what we do spend money on. Apart from our normal household bills, most of us will spend money on other things as well. It might be going out for a nice meal, it might be gym membership, trips to the cinema, books, a little bit of a weakness of mine, along with the ATM, know all about my slight problem with buying wool. There are things that all of us will do that we perhaps could think a little bit more carefully about, and I'm trying to think more carefully about whether I need some of the things I buy or whether I can be a better steward of that money. And that's something for each to think about. Think, reflect, and pray about your response to your giving and how you use your financial resources. And when thinking about that, it's really good to think about the priority. How important is what you give to God financially in your life? On a Sunday morning, do you pat your pocket and say, oh, this is what I've got in it, this is my collection? Or do you plan it ahead? Do you think about it? How important is it in relation to the other things we do? Now, coming on to planning, it's very, very... Whoops. Excuse me one moment. There we go. It's all back in place now. It's important to plan what we give. Rather than as an afterthought, when you work out your household budget, think about it in the same context. This is my insurance, this is my car, this is my groceries, this is my giving. And that puts it up there as a priority with everything else that you have. Now, proportion, how much should I give? Well, this is different for everybody. And what everybody gives is very much between them and God. The Church of England recommends 5% of your net income. Now, that's based on the biblical concept of tithing, which is 10%. But the Church of England recognises that as Christians, we tend to be very generous to other charities as well, which probably brings us up to that 10%. Now, proportionate giving isn't right for everybody. And if it's right for you, that's super. But if it's not right for you, don't get too caught up about it. Think about what you do give and think, can I increase it? And if you can, please do. Now, when you think and reflect about your giving, it's perfectly fine to realise that you're giving more than you really can afford. And if that's the case, it's fine to reduce that giving. And it might be that you're at the level that you can afford, but you can't afford anymore, in which case stay the same. But if after prayerful reflection, you think, yes, I could give some more, then please, please do. Everybody's situation is different, and it's important that we do what is right for us in our own personal relationships with God. So how much? It should be sustainable. It shouldn't be more than we can afford. Regular giving each week or month means that the treasurer can make really good, sound financial decisions. He can be the good steward of your money. Knowing what he has coming in means he can plan and make savings by doing some bulk buying, some purchasing ahead. So that's very, very good. And it should be significant. It shouldn't really just be an afterthought, whatever you've got. Everybody's significant is different. It should be amount that if I was to hand it back to you at the end of the year, you would look at me and say, thank you, Charlotte, that's really nice. I could do something. I could treat myself. But just remember, it is between you and God, and it's part of our own personal discipleship. And it's nobody else's business what you do. Obviously, if you'd like to talk about it with friends and families, as a discussing generosity, please do, but don't feel that you have to. It is a personal thing. So, how much? Well, here in Whitstable at All Saints, we've got £155 per week shortfall, and that's the gap between our income and expenditure. It works out at £1.22 per regular giver. Now, it's not an awful lot, and it might be that some of you can afford to increase your giving more than that, and if you can, please do, because that will help balance the budget, because there will be some people that won't be able to increase their giving or may have to reduce it. It's a bit like going out for a coffee, and if you go with a friend who's not quite as well off as you, you might say, don't worry, I'll buy you a coffee because I'd like to show my generosity to you. So think about what you do, and when you're thinking of reviewing your financial giving, do review it. Think carefully and take the right action for yourself. Think about any other ways you could help the church in practical ways. And this is quite a big one. If you're not already a member of the planned giving scheme, please do join. It's very, very helpful. It means we can make good, sound financial decisions. And if you're a taxpayer, don't forget the gift aid form. It's basically free money that comes back to us, and it does make a big difference. So, what's the next step? Well, you've all got one of these lovely packs, and as part of the pack, you've got a making the response, and there'll be an envelope there as well. So have a look at that, and after you've thought, reflected and prayed, please do return that response form, if you're able, within the next fortnight, through to the church office. And that will be very, very gratefully received. So, just to end, and this is quite a good slide for such a glorious morning as this. God has been amazingly generous to all of us. He's given us all that we have, the world around us, ourselves made in his image. And he's given us redemption. He gave us his son. And it's only natural, thinking about all that we've been given, that we make a generous response as much as we are able. And I think this sums it up quite nicely. With the whole realm of nature mine, that we're an offering far too small. Love so amazing, so divine, demands my life, my soul, my all.
So Charlotte, tell us what you do in your role for the diocese.
Well, I'm the Assistant Stewardship and Funding Advisor for the diocese. And stewardship is about encouraging a generous response to God throughout the diocese. And we encourage people to think, reflect and pray about their financial response to God's generosity and the response practically with time and talents towards God's generosity. We would ask what's right for them and how important their giving is to them, and if possible to join planned giving schemes. Planned giving schemes do allow the treasurers of each parish to plan and make good stewardship decisions regarding the finances of the church.
Do you find a lot of people think that churches have just got the money and we don't need to give to them?
We get that an awful lot. The church is rich, the church commissioners have got money, but unfortunately that isn't the case. Each parish is responsible for itself. responsibility to make sure that their bills are met and their clergy are paid. That is a different level for each parish, depending on where they are, how big they are, but it is their responsibility to cover their costs. There is no external funding to help them.
And finally, have you enjoyed being at All Saints this morning?
I have enjoyed being at All Saints enormously this morning. It is such a privilege to share in worship with you. A wonderful, varied service with modern elements, traditional elements, in the most beautiful setting. I felt really, really privileged to be here this morning.
Well, thank you very much, Charlotte, for coming.